$2,500 is the average amount people spend on power stations, according to the brands that we work with at least. But what does that actually get you, and what can you power for that price? Unfortunately, the answer isn't black and white, but hopefully today we can make it as simple as possible to show you guys what your hard-earned money can do for you. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Now, $2,500 in this space can actually go a pretty long way.
It can actually get me to Cancun too.
Yeah, well, that's a one-time thing. Now let's assume that you don't want to buy 16 of these tiny little E300s. The units we would actually recommend around the $2,500 price point would be the Delta Pro 3, the Anker F3800, but not the Plus.
The Plus is a little bit more money.
It's a little bit too much money. It doesn't make it in the $2,500 category. You got the two Pecron E3600 with the 240-volt box. And we're going to throw the Delta Pro in, the OG one, just for fun. It's a little bit cheaper. It's like $2,000 right now. With our discount codes, right now, all these units come in around the $2,500 mark. These companies love to wake up and change the price every day, but generally, they're about $2,500 units. So we're gonna do our best to show you what these units can do. If at the end of this video you still want a little bit of help, we have a really simple power station quiz that we made. It'll recommend a unit to you at the end based on the questions that you answer that we actually recommend to you. And of course, we'll leave links in the description down below as well as coupon codes that we can get for any of the products that we mention. But what can you actually power with these units? Now, the most common use case for a power station of this size is emergency power or backup power. The average outage in the US is just a little over 7 hours. We actually feel like they've been a little bit worse lately. They've been a little bit longer. We're gonna use a benchmark example of 24 hours. You'd rather be overprepared than underprepared. So in the example of a power outage, the main things that Google says that people wanna keep powered during this time are a fridge, which is about 1300 watts per day. We made a whole video on that. People misconceive how much power a fridge actually uses. It uses about 1300 watt hours a day. A CPAP, which on the high end draws about 100 watts. A sump pump, which draws on average 480 watts. A router draws on average 12 watts. And some lights, let's just call it 20 watts. You're powering a small amount of lights in your home. So during a 24 hour time frame, you would consume about 1300 watt hours for your fridge. Say you sleep for 8 hours and you got the CPAP running the whole time. That's another 800 watt hours. A sump pump, we're gonna be extreme with this example. Say the power's out because there's a storm and water is just gushing into your pit nonstop. Your sump pump's probably gonna purge for about 10 seconds to get that water out of the pit. And it's probably gonna purge every couple minutes. We'll call it 3 minutes. So if it purges every 3 minutes for 10 seconds, it's gonna purge about 3.3 minutes per hour. So over the course of 24 hours, you're gonna draw about 633 watt hours from that sump pump. The router, 12 watts times 24 hours is 288.
That's the same battery bank as an EcoFlow River.
Holy shit, that's why they made it that big. I can't believe it's for a router. And finally, for the lights, say you run them for about 5 hours, that'd be 20 times five. That's about 100 watt hours consumed of lights. So total, you're looking at about 3,121 watt hours of consumption in that 24 hour time frame. So all the units in our example today would have more than enough power to keep you going through that 24 hour time frame. Obviously, there's idle consumption which comes into play. The unit being on and just running, it's just gonna consume power just for the fact that it's on. So it's not gonna be as exact of a math as we made it to seem, but roughly, not factoring in idle consumption. We mentioned that in like the actual review videos of each product we have on the channel. The Delta Pro would have roughly 479 watt hours of battery capacity left. The Delta Pro 3 would be 879 watt hours. The Anker F3800 would be 719 watt hours left. And the two Pecron E3600s bundle would have just over 3000 watt hours left, which is actually really good.
Enough for another day.
That's enough for another day. Now, of course, that was just our example. If you guys are trying to figure out what a device in your house takes, if you're looking at a fridge, just watch our fridge video. Otherwise, everything will say volts and amps on it. And it's really easy. If you have something that says it takes 120 volts and 5 amps, you just do 120 times five. That device would consume 600 watts when it is running. So you can really easily do some math on the things in your house to find out exactly what they would take so that you can tailor the situation to your own needs. Anyways, so that's what these things could do for the 24 hour period. Obviously the two Pecrons, that's an insane bundle and you basically get double the battery capacity when you hook two of them up together. So that one by far leads the pack with how much power is left over. Mm-hmm. All of these units, except the original Delta Pro, can run 240 volts directly out of the unit. The two pack runs, you plug them in together into that box, that gets you 240 volts. So you can really do a lot with them, considering they can do the 240 volts, aside from running them into a transfer switch or a sub panel in your home, and being able to power pretty much anything that falls within the inverter's limit. With the plugs directly on the units, you can power almost anything you want, from simple things that you might have in your house, like an air fryer or the cooktop on your stove. You could also run bigger, less conventional things like a welder, ported power tools, a car lift, an air compressor, all kinds of things, as long as they generally fall within that inverter's limit. Now, obviously these units won't last 24 hours running these loads, but it is cool to know that if you have a business and you have some essentials that you need to keep on, or if you're just trying to make the most out of your purchase and say the power's out, but for some reason cooking is the most important thing that's going on right now, and you really need to run that cooktop, you can do these things with these units. Except the Delta Pro, it'll only run things that are 120 volts. And aside from all of this, all these units are portable. They can all be used in an off-grid situation. They could be used to power a small tiny home or a cabin, even just outbuildings. You could use them in your RV. Pretty much anything you could think of, you could do with a unit of this size. And they also all charge with solar. So if you're using them in a blackout situation, you don't have grid power to charge it back up, you can run some solar panels directly into these, charge them right up, and basically keep going as long as you're not absolutely beating on the thing. You could run solar into it and continue to use it for as long as you want. We have individual videos on all these units on the channel. We highly recommend you check out the Pecron bundle. Right now, those two units tied together to make it 240 volts is probably the best way you could spend your money on portable power, assuming you're not brand specific to EcoFlow or Anker. You get a huge inverter, a huge battery capacity. It's a pretty good deal, but like we said, we will leave links in the description down below, coupon codes for you guys. And if you're still hung up, check out the quiz. Otherwise, that's all we got for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.